Hello, my name is Wayne Godsoe from the Avaya Serviceability Engineering Team. This tech tip will cover the steps to enable the web server on the Avaya VSP9000 system. Enabling the web server allows you to administer the VSP9000 via a web browser. You must enable the web server interface before you can connect to the system using Enterprise Device Manager. The web server secure only option forces a secure HTTPS connection. For security purposes, the secure only option is enabled by default. You must disable the secure only option to use a standard HTTP connection. In our example, we'll configure a standard HTTP connection. However, Avaya recommends using secure HTTPS connections. In our tech tip example, we will use the following steps to enable the web server on the VSP9000. We'll log into the system with read-write all privileges using our RWA user account and RWA password. We'll enter terminal configuration mode by entering enable followed by the conf-t command. We'll enable the web server on the VSP9000 system. We'll configure the username and password for read-write all web server access privileges. We'll configure the web server to allow standard HTTP connections. We'll verify our web server configuration changes with the show web server command. And finally, we'll save our web server configuration changes with the save config command. In our example, we'll log into the console with the read-write-all user account and password. Now we'll enter terminal configuration mode, typing enable, followed by the conf-t command. Now we'll enable the web server with the web server enable command. Next, we'll configure the username and password for our web server. We'll assign read-write-all privileges for the username admin and use the word password as the login password for the admin account. Now we'll configure the web server to allow standard HTTP connections by turning off the secure only option using the no web server secure only command. Now let's verify our configuration settings with the show web server command. From the screen output, we can verify the web server status is on, secure only mode has been disabled, and the username and password have been set to allow web server access. Finally, we'll save our configuration changes with the save config command. As you can see, enabling the web server in the Avaya VSP9000 is a quick and easy process. You must enable the web service before attempting to administer the Avaya VSP9000 with Enterprise Device Manager. Thank you for your time today. We welcome comments, questions, and feedback at mentor@avaya.com or on Twitter at Avaya Mentor. For more details or related information, please visit support.avaya.com. Thank you for choosing Avaya.